dices ahorita que me quieres a tu lado. Qué lindo sería si tú me das, te invito a que dejemos todo a un lado. Que empieza la liga, yo sé que me dices que sí, que sí, que sí, que sí. Yo sé que me dices que sí, que sí, que sí, que sí. Yo sé que me dices que sí, que sí, que sí, que sí. Yo sé que me dices que sí, que sí, que sí, que sí.
Yeah, we're well into the second half of the Sportsmax Zone for this Monday. Time now for our La Liga segment. And this segment brought to you by Omega XL. Round 32 of Spain's top flight concluded on Monday with two games in the early match. 11th place Mallorca faced off against Athletic Club, who are fighting for a place in Europe next season. Here's what happened at the Mallorca Stadium.
11 minutes played, still goalless. Now Berenguer's cross, Iñaki rising, couldn't quite make contact. It was a lovely cross for Kang In Lee to deliver. And it's a good ball as well. It's towards Morici, comes down to Kang In Lee, and a chance for Morlanes. And they find Morici. Deep delivery, headed back across goal by Maffeo, and there's a real bundle for it. Pressure broke down because it was Mallorca's best moment of the game so far. Corner from Kang In Lee, headed back across goal by Maffeo. Morici throwing himself at it, swiped goalwards by Valiant, but block. He will deliver. And he's headed down on target by Paredes. Vivian with a poor pass, and Morici's in. Crosses towards Morici, it's a great ball. Oh, he misses his kick, but the chance is still there. Kang In Lee, and it squeezes through. Kang In Lee. If there's an offside against Morici, no, there's not. So the goal will stand. He could have scored himself, but then cut it back for Kang In Lee. And just wonder if Urai got a touch on it that moved it away from the goalkeeper, who drives it back. Raul Garcia with the shot that's blocked, and a second shot that's scuffed. You know, I do with the cross. It travels a long way. Raul Garcia with another header. Dealt with by Maffeo. Another cross, this time from Yuri. It's a good ball from the penalty spot. And he takes it, fires it down the middle. Calmly done by Iñaki Williams. And the shot was straight down the middle. And that is the last kick of the game. Mallorca furious, but it was a handball by Ruiz de Galarreta.
Yes, yeah, so Athletic Bilbao's hopes of a first top six finish in La Liga since 2016 taking another hit here in this 1-1 draw with Mallorca. The final game of the round saw Sevilla battling Girona for a place in the top 10. Both teams went into the fixture with 41 points, and a win would see either team breaking into the top half of the table.
Well, it's Girona who get things underway. They are starting, going off from left to right by a couple of sets of fans. As this ball finds its way across, falls onto the six-yard box. Brian Hill tries to turn. Gomez leaves that. It's Acuña who swings it over. It's knocked out. It's across the face of goal. Montiel and Ocampos playing on that right-hand side. This ball comes to the back post, and it's hooked into the net. Brilliant hit. It's the...
And Juanpe did it very well.
Juanpe takes a step out. The two defenders get in one another's way. Juanpe still had work to do there. It's so hard to connect on that and turn it into the net. The angle was narrow. The connection was true. Girona take the lead. It's Sevilla nil. Girona one. Montiel floats one in. Brian Hill strikes. Great save. Switched over there. Here's Brian Hill. Brian Hill tries for goal. Acuña floats that over to the back post. It's Enesiri with the header, nearly finds Ocampos. But here comes Girona on the attack. Maybe the final chance of the first half, and it's off target by Girona. He was perfectly picked out, and he's got options here. Riquelme could go for goal. He's hit the crossbar. It's come back out. Zagankov cuts it back. Castellanos scores. The man in form finds the net. It was all about Rodrigo Riquelme after receiving that pass. To Montiel, breaks into the box. Montiel cuts that back. And Ocampos didn't have enough mustard on the finish. Of goal. Lifted in. No header there from Ocampos. And fall for Acuña. He brings it down. And it's poked over the top. Go the goalkeeper's view. And Suso does go for that top corner. But outside to Suso. Suso, ball into the back post. And they can plan for the season ahead from now. This ball bends onto the crossbar. Suso about to call time on this contest. Game over. Sevilla lose to Girona as Girona, the away side, strike twice. In a good performance for them, Sevilla back to the drawing board for them. Girona with two big victories in the space of a week.
Yeah, so it's Girona jumping into the top 10 with that victory over Sevilla. Sevilla really struggling to find their best positions in La Liga, a team with pretty rich history in La Liga and also in Europe as a Europa League champion six times before. And a pretty solid team when it comes to Europa football. Let's have a full look at the results now. Well, from the weekend, Osasuna beaten at home by Real Sociedad 2-0. Elche 4-0 over Real Vallecano. Almeria beaten at Real Madrid 4-2. Barcelona 4-0 over Real Betis. Cadiz 2-1 over Valencia. Villarreal dismissing the travelling Celta Vigo 3-1. Espanyol 1-0 over Getafe. Atletico Madrid winning 5-2 at Real Valladolid. Mallorca 1-1 with Athletic Club, and we just saw the highlights of that game along with the 2-0 victory for Girona over Sevilla in La Liga for round 32. And looking at the table now, Girona with their victory earlier on, moving up to 8th place in the table, now on 44 points, and Barcelona still with their lead at 79 points, 11 in front of Real Madrid, and inching closer to formalizing the La Liga title, which will be their 27th in La Liga. Sevilla failing to beat Girona earlier on today, still outside the top 10 at 41 points in 11th place. And the relegation position teams, Espanyol, Getafe and Elche in La Liga. So La Liga completing round 32, and Mariah's favorite team, Barcelona, inching towards the title. As they are pretty safe, but not finishing with the sort of flourish that you had hoped for.
No, well, I'm happy that you read my mind, because that's what I wanted to talk about. Not that I'm extremely predictable or whatnot when it comes to La Liga. But Lance, we have to actually change the tune of the discussion, because Barcelona getting 4-0 against Real Betis on the weekend. We spoke about, one, them not ending with a bang, and of course me being concerned about that. And two, we discussed them not winning matches by big number of goals, you know, by big margins. But of course, on the weekend, we saw a different sort of Barcelona, you know, a team that played with a lot of life. Of course, Robert Lewandowski getting the goals, Lance, you know, different players stepping up. Rafinha also was among the goals. And I'm happy to see Barcelona doing what I expected of them. I spoke about them ending with a bang, and I spoke about them, of course, trying to rectify that goal-scoring issue that they picked up coming down to the end of the season.
Yeah, I just want to say that I've been saying for the past couple of weeks that they are coasting, Mariah. I know that, you know, Barcelona fans will be very hard on the team, because although they are winning La Liga, the kind of stuttering is not something that the fans want to see, especially as they are rebuilding. And they want to see Barcelona beginning to challenge for, you know, Europe, and challenging for their reputation as a top team in Europe has been tarnished recently. So they want to see those results. Yamin Lala Yamal, a 15-year-old playing for Barcelona over the weekend, the youngest player ever to represent Barcelona. So in this rebuilding phase, I guess that's partly a good story for them as well.
Yeah, and I think what I have been very proud about Barcelona about is not only about winning titles, but the fact that they really groom youngsters, and they start them off at a very, very young age, Lance, because Ansu Fati was one that had come to the scene. You know, it's unfortunate that we don't get the sort of performances that, you know, he started with, and of course I hope that he can rectify that patch that he's undergoing. Injuries of course had a part to play in it, but they're known for spotting the youngsters and of course molding them, and that's very, very commendable.
Yeah, well, let's see what Yamal has to offer in the coming weeks as he tries to rivet himself in the Barcelona roster. We go to break, back with more on The Zone after this.
Que sí, que sí, que sí. así tal cual, flow bien natural. Yo te quiero así tal cual, flow bien natural.